Hello everyone, this is Mommy and Who here, and welcome to more Let's Play Splatoon! And sorry that really annoyed you. Last time, we got messy in Splat Zones, and we did a pretty good job there. This time, we're going to start Rainmaker, but first, this has been long overdue. I'm going to showcase Spike here. Hey there. So what will it be? So yeah, Spike, this is this sea urchin guy. What you can do is two things. As you can see, you got order slash pickup and slots. Now I can talk to this ink by here. It says, my boyfriend left me, who cares? If you press the white button, you actually ordered clothing for another inklings. You can order them, they can order enough on Spike, and during the next 2-3 days, see here, Spike can get that clothes for you, and of course you gotta buy as well. Sometimes they'll come with the same gear they have, or they'll come with no sub-abilities equipped. As you can see here, if I get my clothes stuff I ordered, here are the Black Sea Shoes, but unfortunately, no sub-abilities. So, I'm not buying it since I've already got every piece of clothing in the game anyway, minus the legendary cap, but now slots. You can do two things. You can add more sub-abilities. Slots to your gear like this, and if your sub abilities on a piece of clothing is full, you can reroll them, and hopes you can get a perfect reroll, but that you should get free the same ability, which is very rare, and you want to get free of the same sub abilities on one piece of clothing. It'll take many rerolls. It's all completely lock based. Sorry, but this not like Pokemon. Now to pay for slots or rerolls, you are given a Super Steel Snail or 30,000 coins. Now to get Super Steel Snails, you need to participate in a Splatfest. But since Splatfests are over now, if you win 10 matches in either Turf Wars or Wank Bell or whatever, Charge will actually give you a Super Sneeze Cell instead, since Wayne Bell's over. But anyways, Rainmaker. In Rainmaker, team complete an Asophis and Rainmaker weapon, which I have it, get to the goal, and the other team starts on the map. So as soon as the battle begins, grab that Rainmaker. The Rainmaker is guarded by a shield, so you need to bust it out first. Once you got it, head for the goal. Hurry, you ain't got all day. If you run out of time and get splattered, the Rainmaker will be dropped. Its shield will also reactivate. If you are on your side of the map, it will return to the center position. Good. The Rainmaker is heavy, so you can't super jump while carrying it. The teammates will have to watch your back. The Rainmaker could also shoot ink like an Inksuka, so you can clear a path. Hold the setup button to charge the Rainmaker up for an extra powerful shot. The closer you get to the goal while holding the Rainmaker, the lower your goal distance will drop. If you retreat too far while holding the Rainmaker, it'll explode sooner. If the match ends without anyone reaching the goal, the team with the lowest goal distance wins. In this way, battle points are awarded based on goal distance. Using the turbo to plan your next move is the key to victory. So that's just the Rainmaker. So here we go, Rainmaker. Transport the Rainmaker. Now, Rainmaker is pretty much the last game mode that was released in this game. This mode wasn't released until at least August of 2015. Which was a year ago, jeez. So yeah, Rainmaker. I'm not sure if I like this more than Splatoon. But I see all you gotta do is grab the Rainmaker and take it to the enemy's base in order to win the game. As long as you gotta pop the shield first, or the enemy teams are of course might have to when you try to get the Rainmaker. And just like Splatoon, it is completely chaotic. And you're gonna die a lot. But that's going to be the case for all ranked battles, no, whether it be Splatoon, Rainmaker, or the third one, which I'll be covering, which is Tower Control. No matter what, you're going to die an awful lot in Rainmaker. I mean, a lot, so just try your best and try to get the Rainmaker as far to any race as you possibly can. As you can see here, I'm using the dual switcher now. Mainly because I kind of want some extra range. Why choose a 52 Gale deco is just so it can pop the Rainmaker shield a bit faster than a 52 Gale. I don't know. So, here I ignore the Rainmaker and try to make a path for the Rainmaker. And Echo Care is a good thing, so you know where the enemy team is, so you don't get splattered in. Like in this case. So yeah. Also, he's losing a splash shot. It's kind of weird to see that. Not many people use no splash shot anymore. They haven't used ten attacks or wasabis. But I digress. So yeah. This is Rainmaker. Pop that Rainmaker shield. This is pretty much a literal tug of war. And you can throw Bonza if you have enough inks. It'll pop the Rainmaker shield but much more quickly. And yeah, Lunar Blasters. Like I said, Lunar Blasters are my least favorite weapon in the game. And they are absolute. And they're just flat out demonic in rank modes. There we go. Phew. Stayed alive. If long, go in a Rainmaker. If one of your teams gets a Rainmaker, you should make it your first priority to get within as quick as you can. So the enemy team will not get the advantage. And even if you pop the Rainmaker, an enemy team can still grab the Rainmaker and vice versa. If the enemy team pops the Rainmaker first, you can still grab the Rainmaker. So yeah. Got splatters, trying to get power, but I got caught by enemy ink again. You've already killed a whale. Curse that slimy person. Give me a comeback. So let's swim right back to the center of the map. See if we can do anything. They seem to pop. They pop the Rainmaker. So. Oh. Unfortunately, the Lunar Blaster gone away. Screw you, Lunar Blaster. All Lunar Blasters need to be thrown in the bin. We do hope that. I hope Blasters in general don't come back in a sequel, but I highly doubt that. I don't see why 10 would remove web. I don't know. Oh look, another suction bomb wash. Like I haven't seen that before. Sarcasm. So let's see. Let's see how far I could take it. I tried to climb here, but I can see there's not enough ink covered on this ground so I can climb up. So I knew he got splattered, but thankfully I didn't. So the Rainmaker as a weapon, it's to rate the Rainmaker as a weapon itself. Well, the Rainmaker is honestly a garbage weapon. It's only thing you need to take the enemy base, and that's about it. It sucks at splatting opponents. Its charge rate is incredibly slow. It's incredibly inaccurate, and it sucks at covering turf too. So do not use the Rainmaker for splatting opponents. Just take Rainmaker to the other side of the map. That's it. So yeah, Rainmaker is basically tug of war, really. Just get you and your team pouring the world until one of them just wins. So I see we got the biggest advantage. All you gotta do is defend the Rainmaker. And it's a good idea to go to the base and try splatting again. Even if you do get splat, it's still a good idea. So there you go, I won. I think that was actually my second match. My first match, I lost the first show. I think it was because it was a 3-on-4. Yeah, and I was surprised. But I kind of out because that was a terrible match. But anyways, this match I did well. I got 15 kills. I can't exactly read that. I think I got 15 kills, so I did pretty damn well. And in this video, you get to see me rank up from A- to A+. No, not A+. From A- to just normal A rank. But you're not going to see that until the end of the video. So, match number 2. We got Gallant, so that was good, but my mortal enemy, the E-Leaders! Again, one of my most hated weapons in the entire game, right next to the Lunar Blaster. If the Lunar Blaster is my most hated short-range weapon, then the Lunar Blaster is my most hated long-range weapon. Look at all that damage up. God, I hate Asian snipers. Well, no, it's just snipers in general. I hate E-Leaders. They can snipe you You can just be out of your business, just try and get a Rainmaker to the other side this time, or in case of working about colored turf, and then found you meanie dead. Why? Because of the Rainmaker. Enough riding the Eelys. I can see here, the enemy team has actually gone on a pretty good push. And I just barely stopped them. And yeah, the enemy team seems to be trying theirs because they want to get pushed, but thankfully, we managed to stop them from getting a knockout, and I believe here, if I'm 1-1, this is where we begin a comeback. Yeah. I mean, this wouldn't be here. For these three main battlefields, I'm going to be showing you matches which I actually won. Maybe a bit point if I show you. Twice I'll show. That's a pretty good weapon, I must admit. I bet she's going to abuse the bowler like hell. I'm not going to be surprised. Yeah. I love the sound of my way falls right into the ink. Makes a good old gloop sound effect. Yep, and that's a Kraken too. That's the E-Leader and got knocked back by from the Rainmaker. Die, E-Leader, thank you. But I got sniped by the other asshole charger, the Hero Charger replica. Which is a weapon that I didn't actually showcase, but it's pretty the same thing as the Splat Charger, so there's really no need to showcase it. When mentioned, it's unlock balls in the description right here. Got sniped once again by the Hero Charger. What a honestly, snipers are absolute monsters. They're not the good kind. I suck at using them, but others are like gods with them. It's just not fair. Isn't that fair? Oh, I got get away. Good thing I managed to avoid it, so I can use my echolocator. And see here, if I'm white, we managed to got the advantage. So I just need to defend the Rainmaker. Well, in this case, get rid of this asshole who's using the Rainmaker. Who sound being godlike with it, because, you know, screw snipers. At least said the F word there. I'm not going to. Damn it. There's a twice, I'm sure. Can I get rid of her? No, I cannot. Bangly, the Arcadia managed to get rid of her, so that's good. Let's move on. They're trying to make a big push again. I'm not letting it happen. Good. Just barely got the advantage right now. I actually got their pick a push. Well, I'm not losing this match right now. No, so we. Oh, thank God. Someone's managed to splat in. And is there someone up here? No. There's someone down there, though. So, let me just get up there. Get rid of these two snipers. Oh, that feels so good. And now I should create a path to where the Rainmaker needs to be. On that, this platform thingy. Which shaped like a sort of volcano. There's another sniper. Stay out. And we somehow lost the Rainmaker. I didn't even see such. No. Try a slasher, stop game away. I mean, that's one thing I really hate about playing Splatoon Online. I try to just do something like covering the whole map in ink or getting the Rainmaker to the outside when an enemy team just has to get in the way and stop all my progress. It's just so annoying, but hey, it's what I need to do, otherwise they'll lose. So, why expect this is a competitive game? Just. Whatever, I'm just complaining about something that doesn't need to be complained about. I don't know what I'm saying. So, just 10 more seconds, make sure they don't grab the Rainmaker. They popped it. No one's grabbing it, thankfully. I got the Rainmaker, so no one's getting it, and we won! See, even when the enemy team has a gigantic advantage, I think we're not going to win this. Things like this can happen. You can actually get a milk. Miracle-like comeback and still manage to win. Guess that's the beauty of this game, despite all of its annoying issues. This should be, and this should be 20 minutes long, but I decided to extend it a bit because I want to see me go from A minus rank to A rank. So there we go. Still got to face against snipers, but this time I got a sniper on my team, and it's the hero Charger Replica. He's done quite a few tests too, and I hope he or she does well. Since all these matches are showing you are wins on my part, of course he did well, I think. They bought the Rainmaker, so I take a different approach so I can get rid of Sniper. But she still managed to snipe me. See what I mean? I hate Elias, even when I try to get rid of them, they still managed to snipe me. I hate them so much. The other team's got a decent advantage. That's pretty much the time. One of my team's got this Splat Bomb Wash, which is good. Now just continue on and get the enemy team out of the way. I'm gonna get splat here, I bet. And then what I need did. Just hide in here. Set an echo locator, which is always a good thing. Get rid of that ED or splat, I don't know. And there's a blaster. I bet it's a lunar blaster. I could be wrong. And of course I can't climb the wall. Because of that asshole, Selena. I was trying to climb the wall, would you please let me climb the bloody wall? Oh, well, too late anyway. You ain't the killer world, bit too far left, matey. I should use the dual scorches wing to my advantage and pop the windbreaker just like that. He can grab it. I'll get you out of the way. You don't have to slam anyone, and a trade. Fair enough. Octoshock Replica. Again, one of the overused weapons in the entire game. Because it's basically the Titan Tech who didn't paint job. So. They popped the Rainmaker. So I grabbed it. I'm not letting you make a push. There we go. Although that charge is really after my blood. Give me this guy if I can. Fix a weapon blaster. So no, it's not a loot blaster this time. And I know more I can avoid. Get away that kid, get away Selena. That sniper douchebag. They can wait. Where's my team? I just realized. Probably doing Step War. I will put them way mega. It wasn't for Selena again. For God's sake, leave me alone. Which is stupid, she wouldn't leave me alone. She wants to win. We all want to win. Yeah. Once this guy has to win, it's not gonna be you. The competitive energy in this game. I love it and I love it and I hate it at the same time. But at least we got a trade that time. CC, screw you, Selena. But honestly, you are worth very good player. It's just that we don't like facing against sniper players. Just don't take my insults and threats too seriously. It's all just for fun, you know. Yeah. So I got a Rainmaker. Trying to make the path clear, but I'm not splaying anyway. This probably shows how terrible the Rainmaker really is as a weapon. So I think I'll climb up here. My plan is, there's only teams there too. That's not a plan, God, Rainmaker. If you're holding Rainmaker, the whole enemy team can see you on the map on the Wii gamepad, so just try to avoid the enemy team. You can, because they're all in the heart of your blood. Which is why you need your team to get rid of the teammates, get rid of the other team. Team. Flexing team. T. Got the Rainmaker again. Trying to make some sort of push. Got splattered, of course, by the E-leader! But it's an eight some sort of push. We're still at a disadvantage. We still have an eight sort of push. The enemy team still has the advantage. Just why isn't my team Why isn't my team doing any sort of efforts? Well, they are doing now. It's doing the last 10 seconds. There was a bunch of lag happening. But thankfully, I finally managed to push the bloody Rainmaker to the... so that we had the advantage and we won the match. I mean, overtime is happening now, so they could easily took an advantage back and won a match, but I got splattered. You think, oh no, we're gonna lose, but no, someone splattered, and we might still won that. So that was a wee frustrating battle. We were at this first for the entire match, and we only won in the last 10 seconds. When my team's finally decided to kick into gear and actually done something. And got the last silver bits in my Black Sea Suit, and something else. Quick Super Jump, which is a meh ability, but it's alright. Not terrible. So there you go. The last A minus match for me at least. Now I gotta lose about some my team, which I also have no idea how to feel about that. Actually, I'm using Seekers. I switched to the 52 Gal. Dragon with a sniper, but of course he still managed to get rid of me. Seriously, why do so many people have to use the Elitist so much? I hate them. And of course the enemy team gets the advantage. So all we need to do is get rid of the enemy team and push the Rainmaker into their base. Which is of course much, much more difficult than it is. Cause they're trying to do the same thing. I mean, it's just a tug of war nature that he's like, man, he got spared. Spared with a solid splash shot. And Jesus Christ, that's way too many bomb explosions happening. I'm not sure if that was a splat bomb wash, a suction bomb wash, or both. But yeah, we just need one more point to get the advantage. Yes, please, enemy team, pop the Rainmaker so that we can get the advantage. That was always last shot is a jumping asshole. A jumping loony. And for some reason he's the enemy teammate is pushing it into the Rainmaker into his own base. But now he isn't. He's letting a life harder than it needs to be now. And I got splattered by Despite that teammate, whoever he was, used another suction ball. So yeah, there's another suction ball which abuser. I'm so sick of people using suction. I know it's a good special, but please knock it off. Hang off the Seekers. There's a Waymaker. For some reason he's can be over there. I just need to pot this Waymaker and push into their base so we can get the advantage. There's fortunately a sniper there, and of course this is bad. I got sniped. For some stupid reason, I couldn't splat her in her general vicinity. I guess the Rainmaker just has piss poor range. I spam to me because I'm getting really salty at this point. And yeah, things just get really weird really chaotic here. People throwing bombs left, right, and center. They got the Waymaker somehow. I might splat the E-Leader somehow. And I got splattered by the Rapid Blaster. At least not bloody Lunar Blaster, which is on our team. And thankfully, one of my team has managed to finally push the bloody Waymaker into their way. So now we finally had the branch, and I got sniped again by the bloody E-Leader. Have I told you I hate E-Leaders again? Because I keep getting sniped by the center. Sewer joining there was a horrible decision because I got killed as soon as I landed there. But guess what? The E-leader! Screw E-leaders! But yeah, now the EMT's got a base. Now it's just gotta get rid of him before he makes any some sort of put. Once again, the suction bomb was special yet again. Surprised it's a weapon blaster. It's not a special medic or bay pro, it's a weapon blaster. But seriously, knock it out with a suction bomb. Just can't we spook people away from the Anyways, guys, we just need to defend the Rainmaker and we won this match. Just enough with this frustration and chaos. Go, you E-leader. Well, it's either I fall in the water or I get sniped. So I'll accept fall in the water because at least that's less. At least I died by myself and not the bloody E-leader. Don't know why Rainmaker's in our base now. That's probably not a good sign. And you get rid of his teammates. Why? Of course not, because that roller got in the way. And surprise, it's not a crack on Splat Roller. There you go, as soon as they do have the Rainmaker, we should win. And of course, they do have the Rainmaker, so we gotta get with it as quickly as we can. Gotta get Rainmaker, and we got Mass Batman, and we won the match. You're welcome, people. So that was a really frustrating match. Definitely did not like playing that match. That was extremely frustrating. But we still managed to win. Me and my teammates, I honestly did crap. I got splat more turns than actually splat people. But however, I still won and I now A rank. Normal A rank. I'm getting closer to S plus, but I'm not holding my breath. So yeah. That will do it for Rainmaker. Next time on Let's Play Splatoon, I'll be showcasing the last rank battle mode I got to showcase. And that'll be Tower Control. So this is Morgan Who. And I'll see you next time for more rank battle chaos. See you later, guys.